So this is my local SEO guide on how I managed to gain over 10 million impressions in the past 16 months. And it just occurred to me really that I've had some success in all the things I've done with local SEO and improving my marketing, improving my website, getting it more greater exposure. And some of the things that I've used for my business as a web designer of 20 years could also be translated into what your business is all about. And I'm sure some of these approaches and the local guide that I'm going to give you today could be applied to your business. So what is it that I did? There's a few things I did, and I have to say that it does take time, but certainly using a blog is one thing, making sure that blog's optimized and regularly adding information that's useful to your clients. That was the first type of mental approach I had. Adding to that, the importance of video, because that keeps people on your web page. And the longer they're on your web page, the more likely that gives a signal to Google that that content is valuable. And once Google realizes that your web page, your content, that blog post you've put together is more valuable, then Google promotes it. So that's the kind of principle used right at the beginning of my approach 16 to 20 months ago when I started writing articles for my website. So recently occurred to me that some of that information and some of those things I've learned, I've never really shared with you before. And so I think this is going to really help your business if you follow the process of some of the things that I've done. So I'm just going to look at some stats with you, share some of my analytics, show you some of the tools I've used to get there. And hopefully by the end of this, you've got a good overview of what you could do to get a similar amount of traffic to your website. And obviously it does vary depending on the demand, depending on how many people are looking locally. And also, of course, you do get a national SEO benefit too from those articles. So I'm now going to share with you some of those genuine figures that I had that really kickstarted my business.
First of all, I'm just going to show you how I get my stats and how that works. And I use SiteKit, which is from Google, which is a really helpful tool because what it does, it brings together the analytics here. It brings together also your search console and also looks at things like page speed and so on. So if I go down to here as well, I can check my pages. It looks at each individual page within my website. Keep an eye on also my things like a desktop. How fast is it loading? Which is, these are going to be important rank factors for SEO in 2021 on the next Google update, which is coming up. But I can also check to see how things are, so I can see I need a bit of an improvement here. Now what this is also showing me is how certain queries and SEO words that I've been working on, what type of impressions I've been getting and the clicks through. Here I get the impressions as well over the past 90 days, and I can see how things are improving. Now SiteKit is just kind of one easy way of viewing stats within your WordPress website. If you want to know more about it, if you type in Zanet, and then generally if you type in something you're looking for that you know I've covered, so in this case SiteKit, and you'll notice here I've got a couple of videos, one about how to install SiteKit if you haven't done so already to integrate that within your WordPress website. And here you've got various chapters you can go to. So if you want to know how to activate the plugin or just how to get the new plugin, because that came out in 2019. Or if you want to know more about how to actually use it, so what it all means, what the stats mean, I've got the video here of how to install it. And I've got the video here, how to use it. So I'll leave those links in the description below. And I'll also put that at the end of this video if you wanted to head over to those after this video. I put out there just a few days ago, would you like to see more tips on Google My Business? Or an A to Z, which I've been compiling, as well as a 30-day course that I'm also building. So those will come eventually. Or do you want to see something a bit different? So as much as I've kind of niched into the Google My Business area, obviously I'm just sharing what I've learned. My stats were round about zero or just a few thousand on a regular basis. And you can see it kind of rockets up and up and up. And then we've got the pandemic and there's been lockdowns, and that's kind of affected my business as it has with many other businesses. So this was kind of in a projection, but obviously it's had a little bit of a setback. I also don't blog as much as I did. And there's quite a few things I've been doing in the past that I've kind of held off now because I've been getting more involved in producing videos to help you. But I want to show you what I did to get this performance. And if I look at it in terms of clicks as well, you can see that obviously if you get the impressions, the clicks also follow.
And also just to kind of inform you of the type of story that I had. So basically, after designing for 20 years and having people constantly phoning me, suddenly, with never marketing before, never advertising before, I decided to start advertising. So I advertised on Bing, advertised on Google AdWords, or ads, I think they're called now. And I had no response at all. I was paying good money and getting no inquiries at all. I then started contacting local businesses. They ignored me, and I was just considered someone just spamming them, in effect. I even sent videos to people they didn't want to know. And it got to the point where I wondered, what else could I do? So I decided to actually just try hard to do my own local SEO. And I'd done SEO tools in the past. I'd read what people promised works and it didn't. And I just thought, I'm just going to work hard. So a bit like a decorator, he decorates other people's houses. Actually, if you go to his house, his is the one that probably needs decorating most. I realized that as a web designer, I'd given all this good advice to other designers or to other businesses, how to optimize their websites. But I'd not really focused on marketing my website, so that got business. And so I kind of put into action some of the things that I've been teaching. And now I then could start to see the improvement. And then I decided to share that with you through videos. And videos actually produce more traffic to the website. And now it's got to the point where I don't actually write many blogs. I tend to just produce videos because that seems to have a real demand at the moment. And every so often I'll put one or two of those videos on my website, as we'll go on to show you in a moment.
Okay, so how did I get this traffic then? What was it that was working? Well, a few things really to consider. First of all, I kind of wanted to know what it was it that people were looking for. So you can do some keyword research. There's plenty of websites and places you can go to. Obviously, Neil Patel's got a great tool called Uber Suggest. That's one option. And there's other options as well that you could look at. But once you know the types of keywords that your people, your audience are searching for, then it's about trying to write articles that are going to be helpful and at the same time are going to be linkable. Why would someone want to link through to this? Well, because you can speak their language, you can understand what they're going through, you understand some of their pains, and then there's lots of things you can do from an SEO point of view. So let me just take you through some of those things. First of all, just have the article with links through to the relevant chapters, have H1, H2 tags, an FAQ system in here that gets picked up. It can take these questions and produce that in the search engine results. Useful graphics that people may want to put on Pinterest, and something that will help them, and they can click on it and enlarges it to help them as well. And explaining things through what people really are looking for. So think about, if I go to here, local SEO for small business ranking. So that's exactly what I'm doing. I'm helping them to see how to do local ranking. It's done through behavior. It's done through things like reviews. I've got then the video, and this is why my YouTube video, really, my YouTube channel started, was just producing videos that I thought people would be interested in. And so I produce videos. Now, why is videos helpful for my website traffic? Well, I mean, it could be that you're a gardening business or you're an estate agent, and it could be that just having videos on the website, rather than viewing it through YouTube, they just press play and they just watch it here. So I'm pressing play and I can listen to this video. And what this is doing is it's keeping me on this page. Now, Google knows through SiteKit, through its analytics, through its Search Console, it knows how long you as a visitor stay on my webpage. And if you stayed on here for, say, 5 minutes because you've watched a video, that gives great signals to Google. So what we've done is not only have we answered the question that's the key word that people are searching for in my audience, but I've now made it so that it's attractive to read. It's not too long. It's got plenty of graphics. It's got a video that gives the full information, which then they may well subscribe to. And then that continues throughout the rest of the article. Again, a bit more graphics, which people might link through to, explaining various things, screenshots as well. Again, a bit more information, screenshots again, and then a conclusion to tell people what to do next and what they can do, and also some social shares. Now, when you put all those things together, that not only is an article that's easy to read, but it also has a video embedded. It also uses all the correct SEO terms like H1, H2 tags and the search engine. And that's really been what's produced that type of information. People now link through to it. When they link through to it, they're giving Google another signal that this is linkable, this is worth linking to. On top of that, I use Nitro Pack, which makes it load a lot faster. So that kind of produces a much faster loading part of the website. I use AMP as well, which is something you may want to look at, that makes it much more quicker again on slower devices. So if I type in AMP, so you go straight into a large photo. There's some information. There you go. Then you've got the same information there, but so much cleaner. Why would anyone do that? Well, because that that works and loads a lot quicker on mobile devices. And so that again gives another good signal to Google. There you go. So local business ranking with Google Accelerated. So it's a Google Accelerated mobile pages. If you click on that, the video that explains how you can get AMP on your website. So you notice that I've kind of now started to brand myself so that if anything that's of interest to you, you want to find more information about it, then you can type in Zanet and then whatever it is that you're interested in that I've covered, and it'll come up. And Google's loving the fact that I'm being found, and it continues to produce that as well.
So I mentioned earlier in the video that I'll show you how to integrate Sitekit into your business website, particularly if you've got a WordPress business, then you'll find this really helpful. Sitekit's a great free bit of software from Google. It combines analytics and Search Console. It also looks at page speed, and page speed is going to be particularly important in the coming month. Why? Well, because Google now is going to start rewarding websites that load fast, that use AMP, which I mentioned also earlier. It's AMP, Search Console, speed of your site or page insights, and making sure it's mobile friendly. All those things are beginning to become more and more important in Google's eyes, and they're going to reward you for those things. So if you want to know how to install Sitekit, visit me here. If you want to understand how Sitekit works and how to understand it, then visit me on this video, and I'll see you there.